13-month-old male, 7.5 kilogram in weight. His mother complains about his easy fatigability during feeding, his rapid breath rate and failure to thrive. On physical examination, he was taşıplak and snake on inspection, high intensity and single
sex. 25 parça, 1000 lirası. 80-60. Evet, 80-60.
And he had 2 out of 6 systolic murmur at upper left sternal border. Chest x-ray showed moderate to severe cardiomegaly and sinus tachycardia was present on
ECG. 0.20. Transthoracic
echocardiography revealed large tubular-like PDA. With a diameter of 5 millimeter with 2D and 6.2 millimeter with color flow. No pressure gradient was present between descending aorta and pulmonary artery. The shunt was predominantly from left to right and left heart chambers was enlarged with left ventricular and diastolic diameter 3.1 centimeter. And mean pulmonary artery pressure was 80 millimeter mercury by mild PR. And we intended to close this PDA and before we intended to perform hemodynamic study.
Hemodynamic study.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we hear you.
Did you hemodynamic study?
Yes, actually we initially did a hemodynamic study and the pulmonary artery pressure was 66 over 40 and with a mean of about 50 millimeter mercury. And simultaneous aortic pressure was 85 over 45 with a mean of 60. Like there was like 10 millimeter mean pressure difference between aorta and the pulmonary artery on room air. But the patient was intubated at that time, inhaling 21% oxygen. The calculations came out that the PVR was about 5.2 Woods units and the SVR was 16.2 Woods units, so the PVR-SVR ratio was about 0.3. At that time, what we did, maybe you can show us the angio. We gave 100% oxygen for like 10 minutes. And then the PA pressure came down a little bit further and the mean difference between pulmonary artery pressures were about 25 millimeter mercury after 100% oxygen. Then we put a Berman catheter and then we tried to close the PDA with the Berman.
Get it?
Can you see the pictures?
Yes.
Okay.
İlk slide. İlk yer.
Just a second. Okay, so what we did, we here like we closed the PDA transiently with the Berman, and then the PA pressure came down even further, and the mean PA pressure went down to 25 to 30 millimeter mercury. So we thought we were pretty safe to close with this PDA, and then we had to decide what kind of device and what size we were going to use. So if you can show us the next picture. This is the aortic injection and show the right oblique. This is the right oblique and so actually from the lateral we measured the smallest diameter of the PDA about 4.3 millimeters and the aortic ampulla was about 9.5 millimeters and the length of the ductus was about 7.8 to 8 millimeters. So at this point, what would you suggest us to use? What kind of device and what should we do, you think?
Any comments?
This patient is 7 kilos and the descending aorta is about 7 millimeters.
I couldn't hear the joke. Any comments, Edwin?
Can I have a question, Ian?
açık mı?
In the testing, yeah. And the testing, Gilem, would you usually do a balloon occlusion testing, or you just do it?
Well, we actually in this case we should have just go ahead and do it because the pressure were coming down with oxygen anyway. But
oh,
I just wanted to make sure on the safe side. So.
Because what stuck in my mind was the 80 pressure on the PA. So.
In fact, for the after the hemodynamic study, we have no doubt about the pulmonary hypertension if it is reversible or not. We think that we have to close this because the hemodynamic study permits this.
Okay.
But just to show and for practice also, we did it.
Okay. Yeah, we don't do that regularly. So.
All right.
And sometimes we just use the device to do that test.
And also we did the balloon before we have already done the measurements because we know that the balloon could change our measurements.
So the best person to advise you what device is Dr. Omar Galal.
Okay.
Yeah, after this excellent...
We'd like to hear what you
say. No, I would suggest the following. First of all, the pulmonary hypertension to block with a balloon is a good... But we had also problems with that. Like we blocked it, PA pressure went down, we put a device, but actually the pressure was high. So we have to probably give the child after closing the PDA, sildenafil or something, assuming that life is not very simple sometimes. 7 kilo baby, what are you going to put? You need, I think Occlutech device is not bad because then you have almost like an VSD device because the Occlutech is the reverse amplatzer. The Occlutech, the bigger number is from the pulmonary artery. I think I would put here like 6 by 8, something like this. But having said so, we were also tricked. Occasionally, suddenly you have something huge in the aorta. So it's not an easy case because of this 7 kilo.
Yeah, you're right. That was our actually...
Could we see the other projection? Could we see the RIO?
Sure.
I think in the RIO projection, the morphology is a bit more promising, I would say. It's a more conical, with a sufficient length and the possibility to put an ordinary plug.
Yeah, exactly.
In spite of the fact that it's a pretty, very, very large duct, no question about it. But I would suggest that an ADO1 large enough to, well, not to be in the aorta, but more or less within the duct. That's what I would try to do.
Okay. Yeah, well, we had a discussion here among ourselves, and also we were between the two devices, ADO1 8 to 6 or ADO1 10 to 8 to 10. So actually half of us thought that we could have it could be okay with the 6 to 8 ADO1 device, but we actually... Because we were worried about the aorta, as you said, we may cause an aortic coarctation.
The other things you should be worried about by 10 to 8 is that the external rim is not always 2 millimeter. Actually, 10 by 8 is 3 millimeter. So
right.
Suddenly you have 10 plus 6.
It's 16, yeah.
So it's huge.
Exactly. So, but as
so you have to, either you go with 8x6 or you have to think of something else.
Yeah, well, as Mario pointed out, from the RIO view, we felt a little bit more comfortable that we had a reasonable aortic ampulla there and a long duct. So we thought we could just pull the device into that duct and we can maybe avoid aortic coarctation. And so we actually tried to go there with that 8 to 10, even though we had the thought that if it looked really large or if we had any gradient, then we could just take it out and put 8 to 6. Mm-hmm. But, you're serious. So, this is what we did. Yeah, next one. Next. It looked really large actually, but we pulled it back all the way into the duct. And eventually there was no gradient at that point. So what would you like to do at this point? Should we release it or should we, you know, because sometimes after you release, the device moves and it may cause a coarctation afterwards also. So we were having discussion whether we should release it now or not. So there is no gradient at this point.
Which size device? Which
10,
size?
8, 10.
On the other hand, we want you to know that the Burman Katarban, it was fully enveloped, thoroughly goes and to come to pulmonary artery from descending aorta.
It was very easy for the Burman when the balloon inflated. It was very easy. It was just popping out by itself. So it was a large ductus with a large, with a huge flow. So we were really, we were worried about a 6'8" that could have been small for this patient.
So, okay, who agree in releasing this device? Who disagree not to release the device?
So we have for a reason many brought up, because the moment you leave it, it will go back inside the aorta. We look the tension on the device. Yeah.
So no one agreed to release the device, and five disagree to release the device.
Okay, we release the device.
No, I said no one agreed to release the device.
Yeah, well, what we already did, so.
Okay.
So we will take it out.
You should have, we should have talked to you earlier. So.
Next one.
Bırakmışlar.
Yok ya, yaptık.
Yeah, still, it's a huge. Yes.
And it stayed there actually, and we didn't have any gradient. And we can show you the echo, the small picture down after the release.
Yes, prof.
The echo, even though you see that it's protruding somewhere into the aorta, there was no gradient at all.
No, I think
also
it's very good.
Also, there was no gradient in the pulmonary arteries. If you can.
If
show
I make a comment on the morphology of this duct, usually the lateral view is the projection that. Show you best the morphology of the duct. But in this particular case, I think the lateral view is misleading and the RAO is more accurate because only in RAO projection you could see the ampulla of the duct. And in fact, now you see the duct is in fact in the ampulla of the duct. If you go back in the lateral view, you have a false impression that the device is in the aorta. No, that's the lateral.
Yeah.
You see? Apparently looks like in the aorta, which is not.
So any measurement to the PA pressure?
It's coming laterally from the aorta. That's why it's just, you know, I think it's...
So did you measure the PA pressure after?
There is no gradient in between descending aorta and ascending aorta after...
After release.
Now what is the pulmonary artery pressure?
The pulmonary artery pressure is 33 over 10, the mean of 20. And the aorta is 100 over 60.
Excellent. Yadam, what size device?
8. 8. Okay. 8.
Okay. Thank you. Good job.